This one's for you and me, living out our dreams. We're all right where we should be, with my arms out wide.
Hi, it's Gabi. This is my good friend Jaycee from Top Gun. We're going to teach beginner stretching, so I hope you guys like it. Some of the stretches you're going to do today are with your partner, so make sure you have somebody there to help you.
And some of them are also going to be individual, so you can do them by yourself.
To save some time, we're not going to do some of the warm-ups that we usually do, but it's really important that you warm up about 5 or 10 minutes earlier before you start stretching.
Some exercises you can do include jumping jacks, high knees, and jogging in place.
We've already warmed up, so let's get started. Like I said before, we're gonna start doing some beginner stretches because I've had a lot of people ask me if I can do some beginner stretches, so we're gonna do it today. Some people have asked me how to straighten your knee, how to lock it all the way, and some things you can do are you have to stretch your hamstrings first of all. Like, that's the best thing you can do to make sure that your knee is always locked. So we're gonna do some today.
One of the first stretches we'll be doing is going down in a pike and trying to touch your toes. Hold it for at least 15 seconds and make sure to breathe.
And if you're really flexible and you have really good leg flexibility, try to grab your ankles and pull your chest down. This is another leg stretch for your hamstrings that you can do. Make sure you put your legs about like this, and you have to go down 5 seconds on each side. So hold it for 5 seconds on one side, and then switch. And then the last one you do, you're gonna try to go in the middle and walk your hands back as far as they can go.
Now we're gonna do a pike. Make sure to keep your chest straight and reach down past your toes. Hold that one for at least 15 seconds as well.
And make sure you breathe. Now try to flex your toes and pull your heels off the ground so it can give you an extra stretch. Hold that one for about 10 seconds. And for some people that can't reach their toes, you can get a TheraBand or a stretch band. Put it around your toes and just pull. The purpose of doing these stretches is to really stretch your hamstrings so you can lock out your knee and get really good body positions in the air. A lot of people have been asking me how to get a full split all the way down, and these are some stretches that you can do to help that.
With a partner.
So if your partner can't get all the way down, make sure that her leg is all the way behind her like this, and make sure that if she can't go all the way down, just push her very lightly and hold it for 10 seconds so she can get a good stretch. Where you should be pushing is on the hips, and make sure that her knees are always locked and her toes are always pointed. And also remember not to give up, because some people learn faster and some people just take more time to learn splits. And splits aren't very easy at first, but then it will get super easy. Like me and Jaycee, we both had like Dorito chip scorpions, and now she has an amazing needle and we're both like gumbies now. So it's gonna take a little while, but don't get frustrated, because you can do it.
Here's another partner stretch you can do. You can also do it against the wall. Have your partner lay on the floor and have their arms by their side and slowly push out their legs as far as possible. This will stretch your hamstrings as well as your hips. You can also stretch your splits by pushing her front leg forward, left or right, you can do either, and her bottom leg back, and make sure her knees are locked and her legs are straight. You can push it forward and then over and out. It's important that you always do both sides so one leg isn't more flexible than the other. And over.
Now we're going to start with some butterfly stretches. Now it's really important that when you go, you try to pull your feet as close to you as possible. And try to push your knees down. Now that you've done that, you're going to put your hands down and try to put your knees down to the ground. Hold each stretch for about 10 seconds.
Now in this stretch, remember it's really easy to push down a little bit and not as much in your comfort zone. But if you really want to gain flexibility, make sure to push as hard as possible.
Here's another partner stretch that you use to stretch your hips and your hamstrings. You grab your partner, do a straddle, and have your partner push your legs like this, and have her go down, pull you as much as you can go. If you can't go all the way to the ground, that's okay. Once you hold it for 10 seconds, you switch. Now we're going to do a few of the shoulder exercises. This also helps a lot with your needle because it's super important because when you grab for your needle, you have to have a lot of flexibility when you grab it to go back. So here's one. You could put your shoulder on a wall and just try to lean your body the opposite way that your shoulder is going. Like try to turn it all the way. And hold it for 10 seconds. Also, try to do a low, middle, and a high with your shoulder so I can get all three stretches in your shoulder. And then next, you're going to do the opposite arm because it's also important to do both sides. Here's another shoulder stretch that you can do with a partner. Now your partner is going to have both thumbs facing the ceiling. You're going to take their thumb like you're grabbing their hand and go like this. Make their shoulders touch. If they can't touch, it's okay. But just try to make them touch. And if they do, just cross it over a little bit. Now, as you can see, Jaycee is really flexible in her shoulders. That helps her a lot with pulling her needles. So after that, you're gonna cross it over like this if they can touch. And then after that, you can pull it forward like this.
Another stretch you can do if you don't have a partner is link your arms like this behind your back and go up to a wall, simply bend over, put your arms above, and lift your chest. Here's another individual stretch you can do for your shoulders.
You take your TheraBands And you can sit however you want. Just make sure you're sitting. Take the TheraBands and try to circle it around as far as you can. Try to go all the way around. And then after, you know, it's also a good idea to make sure that your dogs are put away when you're stretching. So if it's easy to grab like this, try to grab a little more in and do it again. Any reverse.
I hope you enjoyed stretching with me and Gabi today.
We can't wait to see you all at NCA. We're super excited. Oh, and by the way, make sure to like Jaycee's page at the top. Bye, everyone! It's really important to take a chocolate break if you're feeling a lot of pain, because it's delicious.
Ooh!
Now, if you can't do it with the TheraBand, it's okay. But if this doesn't hurt you wide, try to go a little closer and circle it.
I hope you guys enjoyed stretching me and Gabi.